Hey everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everybody who has been tuning in for the Isaac series. What kind of run are we going to have today? It's going to be a Lima 1 Zulu Sierra Bravo Lima Quebec Alpha type run. It's probably like the least amount of numbers I've ever seen in the seed. Good tiers rate, not great. Good tiers rate, acceptable movement speed, acceptable damage. We also have the belt and a pill along with the doctor's remote. So, not too bad, not too bad. What is the doctor's remote? It is a spacer item that allows us to use a one-time use predator missile, kind of like Epic Fetus, like that, and then we just reap the rewards. I mean, that's about it. It's about as simple as it gets. No curse? No curse. All right. So it feels a little bit weird playing Isaac right after I got done recording yesterday's run, or whenever this video will go up. I'm trying to make it to where we get like 4 or 5 episodes a week now of Isaac, or every day. I mean, it would be unwise for me not to do Isaac every single day, because Isaac is currently the number one series on the channel overall. But if we're talking about right now, then it's Lobotomy Corporation. I think that everyone pretty much saw that one coming. Well, I mean, you know who's number one. I'm not going to sit here and profess that I knew that Lobotomy Corporation was going to take off. I had no idea, man. And thank you for those of you who have been supporting that series as well. Such a great game. It is such a great game that brings a concept that you never really would have even thought about. And it's also quite the gear shift going from Lobotomy Corporation to Isaac. There's something for everyone over here at twitch.tv/Invicta and youtube.com/Invicta316. That makes you think that I'm actually like simul-streaming this, and I'm not. I'm actually just recording this. Okay. One hit, I can understand. Two hits, costing us 2 soul hearts in a room full of champions, is unacceptable. No matter how you shake it. And I don't even know what that means. Don't shake it. So now we have to go find the shop so I can get back the soul hearts that we lost so badly. And what's nice about Doctor's Remote is that it does, obviously we can use it as a bomb if we really, really need to get out of harm's way. Unfortunately, of course, we can't do that because, well, we didn't get a donation machine. I almost killed myself there. And I had to pull back because I'm an idiot and tried to rush through that without getting the first soul heart, and I hit the spacebar item a little bit too soon. So we don't get the second soul heart, unfortunately. There we go. So that epic feeder shot, it accomplished 2 things for us. Obviously, it dealt a lot of damage to Littlehorn, but also it destroyed the demon fire over there. I don't even know what those are called, what the orange fires are called. I've been calling them demon fires since vanilla. I don't truly know what they're called, though, in the scope of the game. Head on down to the next floor. Good start here. Sloppy in the champion room. Curse the blind on floor 2. Hooray. It's gonna be like that, are we, Isaac? We had the last run here. I haven't even closed Isaac since the last run was recorded. We had that run, which was an amazing run. And I don't even think we had any. Did we have any curse? I think we had Curse of Darkness twice towards the end of that run, and then that was it. But here we are now, just a little bit later, and we've got ourselves Curse of the Blind. Very keen to getting something from this demon judgment, obviously. But what it is, I'm not sure, because it's Curse of the Blind. I really wish that the flies wouldn't do that. They do this little shimmy that will knock around the other flies, and that in turn makes it to where they don't necessarily go where you think they're gonna go when you're shooting them because of the ricochets and stuff. And that throws me off. I mean, I'm still the one who takes the damage, of course. I'm just saying, that's the reason why I took the damage there. I did not even see that torso until it was too late. Okay, let's get a handle on this, because this is just getting awful now. We should not be taking damage as much as we are, especially in rooms like these. Not with this movement speed. I didn't see that torso down there. But the follow-up shot was one that we should not have taken. We've arrived at the moment in time where now we have to pay our dues here for yesterday's run, or whenever that last run was. I say that because I don't know when these videos are going to be coming out, which is sort of the reason why I don't like doing a long backlog here. But as I explained in the last episode, I also kind of need to do that, especially for this week, since we're so far behind with missing work on Sunday. So, Firemine. Firemine does that. It explodes, normally in your face, and deals a lot of damage to you. It can deal a good amount of sustained damage, if you allow it to, on a target that doesn't move. No, there's no way I don't do this in here. Even then, I still kind of don't want to do that, but... But the reason why I and a lot of other people really dislike Firemind is because of the item's tendency to hit Isaac. Quite often, in fact. And it's not a good item. If Isaac was somehow immune to the blasts of Firemind, then yeah, it would be an amazing item. Almost broken, I would say. But since he's not... Yeah. Now, if you're wondering how come there's a fire that's being left by our bombs and stuff, it's because of Firemind, including the... Oh, screw this. It's including the doctor's remote here. Hey! Okay. Interesting. Look, there's no excuse, Brain. There is zero excuse for this. It's not like we were recording a day ago and then we just woke up or something. We literally just got done recording a good run. An amazing run. And now we're doing this stuff. This has got to stop. So we have Placebo, which is going to act like... Think of a Placebo as like the blank card, but for pills. And we found... We just so happened to start with a... We just so happen to start with a health up pill. So we have lots of HP, but is that better than the doctor's remote? I'm gonna say it probably is. Mom's underwear does not help us out, and I would have to use the health up pill to get both of these. Is that something I'm willing to do? Of course it is. Spear of the Night, I will take. And Incubus. Now, was that worth 4 hearts and our health up pill? Probably not. But Spear of the Night does give us flying, which is a huge, huge help. But there was also no way that I wasn't going to take both of those, because we just don't know what they were going to be. I mean, woo! Hey, in a run like this, we have no excuse not to win at this point. The game is actively trying to help us out and try to save me from my own idiocy. So thank you, game. I hear you loud and clear. I will win this run for your sake. Head on down the next floor. I can't believe we just got a random health up pill. I was going to go back and go get the doctor's remote, but now I guess I can't. Now, we have an added problem here with Incubus, and you're probably already seeing it. But the problem is that Incubus is going to cause us to take even more Firemind damage because of the frequency of shots. I don't remember if Incubus can directly proc the explosion, though. I think it can. But there's no real way for me to test that. If you're wondering why I'm not getting those full charges yet, it's because, well, I mean, we might as well just get as much HP as we can. But Spear of the Night's fantastic. It gives us flying, gives us a spectral tear shot, which will go through everything, except piercing. It doesn't count as piercing. And that's a little bit of a mistake that some people make when talking about Spectral Tears. Spectral Tears means that they go through obstacles. They do not pierce enemies and that sort of thing. Not like Sagittarius or Cupid's Arrow, There's a couple other piercing shots that I'm missing, of course, but... Double health up there. What are the other piercing shots? Dead Onion. Polyphemus I call pseudo-piercing. It's not true piercing because while it does technically pierce, I guess, it has to kill something in one hit for it to pierce. And then, of course, Mom's Knife and Death's Touch, that sort of thing. I'm talking about just purely piercing shots, though. You also have the push pin. The push pin will give you a will proc every now and then. Will proc a piercing effect for you. The trinket. And I sort of discounted that range upgrade, like too soon. The range upgrade that we got from Mom's underwear is actually pretty important here, especially combined with the fact that we have aforementioned the spectral tears, because this allows us to exercise our greatest strength, which is going to be our range. And the reason why we need to do that is obviously because we're trying to stay away from the fire mine procs. So the further that we can remove ourselves from that situation, the better off we're going to be. Liberty Cap is very tempting here, but we're going to hold off on it. For the time being, I mean, we might still take Liberty Cap. But the Bloody Penny right now has been doing a very good job at keeping us alive. And what the Bloody Penny does is it will give us a 50-50 shot in spawning a half heart every time that we use, or that every time that we find a pill. Or not a pill, a coin, sorry. We got a moon card. Takes us directly to the secret room. I should have known it wasn't over here. I'm not going to leave this combo away. It's so nice to be able to spawn our own HP whenever we need it. That's a powerful enough combo for me to say, I think we'll hold on to it from now. I am going to take Liberty Cap, though, just to help out with, you know, the usual Sinvictus, blah, 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 stuff. To help speed things up. Hopefully we get the treasure map. That would be a nice little surprise. Oh. My mistake, I didn't realize that you had moved up there already. I mean, Ragmega, I need to be careful in here. There's a tinted rock north of this room. Northwest, to be more precise. There we go, we get Red Heart HP, alright, well... We really don't need any more Red Heart HP game. I mean, I sort of have my own Fountain of Youth here, but... I would have much preferred a Deal with the Devil. And we're still not guaranteed to deal with the devil here. Take that. And I realize some of you might be wondering, well, how come that boss trap or the mob trap room was not open for you on the last floor? So the deal with that is mob trap rooms are the blue swords, the blue cross swords, which I affectionately call mob trap rooms. I'm not exactly sure. I think they're called officially, I believe that they're called challenge rooms. But you can only enter those when you're at full health. And then the opposite is true for the orange cross swords, which I call the boss trap room. And those you can only get in if you have one HP or less. For red hearts, anyway. If you have all soul hearts, then obviously you're going to be able to get them right away. So if no one has ever explained that to you, there you go. I should probably ease off on the health ups now, considering that if we want to get down to full invincibility, it's going to be nigh impossible. Let's let him burn. Let him burn. Burnt mushrooms. What do mushrooms taste like to people? I want to know this. This is something that's always sort of perplexed me. I don't think I've ever truly eaten just mushrooms by themselves, but I remember not being a fan of them. And no, it's not because they're sort of like a pseudo-vegetable or anything like that, because everyone knows that I don't like vegetables, period. Because I'm a giant man-child who never grew up to be past 6 years old. But it's because, like, I just don't... I'm a taste person. Texture, I'm not really a huge stickler on when it comes to... Just texture. I know people who are nothing but texture people. Like the food's got to feel good for them, otherwise they're just not going to eat it. I'm not necessarily like that. Although, if I'm eating a food that tastes really good, but it has a consistency of eating sandpaper, then I'm probably not going to enjoy it as much. But what's the appeal of eating mushrooms? Is it that they're healthy? I truly don't know. This is me asking for an honest answer. Is it like the earthy flavor? I remember it tasting somewhat like dirt. And yes, I realize that that's gonna spawn a whole lot of, oh, you just haven't had it cooked by the right person, or you've never had my mushroom, or something like that. That sort of thing always ends up happening in the end. It's the same thing that goes for vegetables. I ask people, do you like the what's your favorite thing about vegetables? If you consider yourself a veggie eater, do you love vegetables? They make you as happy as meat makes me happy. What's the appeal there? Is it the texture? Is it the crunch? Is it the actual taste? Most people tend to say it's the taste. Some people say it's the crunch. They just like having a little bit of extra crunch in their sandwiches or stuff. I can understand that. But what about mushrooms, though? Mushrooms are something that I always thought would be... You know, of course, we didn't get Deal with the Devil, but hey, we got another Red Heart HP. This is starting to get a little bit ridiculous game. 67.5%, another failure, and another Curse of the Blind. Small rock, I will take. How do you know a small rock? Well, Timmy, it's because it's the only item that can come out of a tinted rock that isn't in a chest. Literally the only item that can. Okay. So here's the problem with me using the combo that we have so flippantly. And that is, if I wanted to build up a little bit of a Soul Heart stash, I can't right now. Soul Heart stash was the name of my adult film counter persona's name, by the way, in the 70s. I'm gonna cheese Liberty Cap here. If you don't. If you don't know what I'm doing here, I'm basically looking at the minimap and walking in and out of a room that I've already cleared to proc Liberty Cap, which will sometimes give you the map, not the map compass effect, but just the compass effect. And that tells me that, you know, hey, I know where this is, or hey, I know where that is. And that sort of thing. Depression, it's not a good item. Retro vision. Needless to say, we will not be holding on to the placebo retrovision wombo combo. Mushrooms, to me, seem like that they would be healthy for you. I love blank card. Especially now that we have a Yara rune. I know that most people say that mushrooms probably are, they probably are, like, good for you. But there's always a chance that they're not. Like, you know, it's like, you could have very good health benefits from having mushrooms, that sort of thing, but there is like that 0.00001% chance that you could instantly die, or your body gets taken over as some hideous fungus monster. But that's a risk you're willing to take. And that's something that I never understood with people who eat like sushi and stuff. Like, I get the appeal of sushi, I really do, I just don't like sushi. I love seafood. Give me seafood and I'm happy. However, I like my seafood cooked. And it sort of speaks to the people who eat, like, what are they? I think it's called fugu. Jar flies is great for us here. Isn't that the puffer fish? I'm thinking of the puffer fish. And for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, you're probably not alone. And secondly, there's a particular type of porcupine fish. Not porcupine fish, puffer fish, what am I talking about? That is extremely toxic, but only the most skilled sushi chefs can actually make it safe. So there's always like this 1% chance that you're going to die for eating this thing, but it's supposed to be super tasty. That's like, that's not reassuring to me. Even if the, even if like the chance of you dying immediately was like 0.000001% chance that you could instantly die in one bite, to me, I don't think it, I think I'm not gonna trust those odds. You gotta remember who this is talking. I'm Sinvicta. I've got the worst luck on Earth. Okay, it's gonna be Gish again. And yeah, that just confirmed, by the way, that Incubus can indeed proc the Fire Mind shot, which is good to know. Again, we're utilizing our range here more than anything, because we want to stay away from the point of impact so we don't hurt ourselves with Fire Mind. And luckily, the game has given us quite a lot of range. And Incubus is also helping out tremendously. Depression is that cloud that you see falling behind us right now. Dark Bomb again, and Dark Matter. Alright, what are you? Oh yeah, Silgish. I should have known that. Why did I not remember that? I could have gone back to get those soul hearts, but eh. Curse of Darkness, hooray. The Jar of Flies, by the way, one of my favorite items in the entire game. Jar of Flies will spawn an attack fly inside of our spacebar item up to 20 for every enemy that we kill. So every enemy that we get a killing blow on, we will, that isn't a fly, we will generate an attack fly. And we can use that for whenever we like. Whenever we like. The most important thing about Jar of Flies is to make sure that you don't let it cap out. There's no reason for you to let the Jar of Flies just be sitting there at 20. You're doing yourself a massive not favor. I don't know what a not favor is. I couldn't think of the word. So depression, every now and then you'll see a little holy light shot come off on one of those, on any mob that's sitting on top of that trail effect, that Aquarius-like effect that we've got. That's from depression. Thanks to Liberty Cap, I knew that the item room would be over here. And we get sinus infection. So if you look at our flies right now, we have 16 flies built up. Lover's card for Dark Bum, might as well. Tarot cloth, by the way, made all those hearts appear because we're using all of our spacebar items or all of our cards twice instead of once. Makes the tarot cloth. Same goes for the error rune. We need to start saving up keys if we go to the chest, which we probably will, because this run is not spectacularly all that powerful. And we also have to be very fully aware of the fact that we still have Fire Mind. Fire Mind goes into a lot of these factors here in regards to me feeling safe or not on this run. I think the boss was over here? I don't truly remember. I think it was. Maybe? We'd love to find the shop. Okay, we're going towards the shop and the boss. Again, if you look at the mini-map, that is Liberty Cap that's proccing right now. So that's what you will see if you have Liberty Cap and you want to find out if you're going the right way or not. Just zone in and out, as long as you do it on a non-curse of the maze floor. Just zone in and out of a room, and it will eventually proc, guaranteed. I say guaranteed because you literally just do that until it procs. There's nothing that will prevent it from procking. I'll take Nun's Habit here, just for S's and G's, and we'll donate our one penny and be done. And be gone! So this is a great room here for us to get a whole lot of flies. In preparation for the mom fight. We missed Boss Rush by a little bit, but nah. Yep, I knew that was going to happen. The last shot always procs on Mom. Fire Mind is actually quite good against Mom if you are able to get a fire underneath the door. No deal with the devil again, so that pretty much guarantees we're going to take the Polaroid and head on down to the next floor. Curse the Lost, of course. And, alright, we've gone... We've gone the wrong way already. I feel the need to keep pointing out how... Okay, it's going to be another wrong direction. I feel the need to keep pointing this out just because of the ridiculousness of the frequency that we find ourselves in with this stupid problem, where I literally and figuratively never find the right way to go until at the very end. Like, one step in one direction, we've already found one dead end. Alright, it's like, okay, well, we'll go a different direction. Then that's also a dead end. It's like, come on. I thought about using the Yara rune here. Only reason why I would do that is if I anticipated there being an item in one of those chests. Which I wasn't really getting that vibe from, but there's also no scientific evidence to back that up. Can you imagine if there's scientific evidence that like, people could use to back up a vibe that they were getting? That'd be scary, wouldn't it? So yeah, so congrats everyone. We've gone in all three directions. The odds of us finding the right door on that was 25%. And not finding a dead end. So, you know, in that sense of what just happened on this floor, that is acceptable, I guess. It doesn't mean I gotta like it, though, because it happens more often than I would hope it would. Thank you, Dark Bomb. Dark Bomb single-handedly trying to save us from this awful damage that we keep taking. Chariot card is nice for the boss. Okay, there's gonna be another dead end here. The cherry card would be nice for the boss, but I don't think we need it. We just have to be careful of getting too close. I need to stop. Oh, okay, there's gonna be another dead end. Whee! Don't ask me how I do it. It's Curse of the Lost. I have no pretenses about this floor or where we're supposed to be going. I'm just going in. Once I find the wrong direction, I just back up and try another one. That always seems to be the incorrect one. So once again, we've run into a situation where three of the directions out of our possible four that we could have gone in that after the mob trap or the boss trap room was going to be incorrect. So, whether that's Sinvicta luck or not, I don't know, but who freaking knows, man. Woo! Alright. Try this one over here, I guess. It's amazing. It really is. Take the soul heart, thank you very much. Will this be the right way or not? Tune in next time to find out. That was a double fire mine proc on the same mob. Thank you, Dark Bum. Dark Bum renewing my faith in the game for trying to help us out. I mean, this has got to be it. This has to be the right way to go. I cannot believe that it's not the right way to go. Gonna be greed. Thank you, Firemind. Alright. Super secret room should be to the right of this room. Where did that bomb come from? Was that a troll bomb left by one of the tentacle things? Or did I accidentally hit the, wow, it's not there. I may have accidentally hit the E key, I guess. That's the only logical explanation. I just saved your life, Judgment. Now I'm gonna end your life. Because you were being a jerk. You give me these payouts. You see that? See what Dark Bum did? You just need to do that. Said you didn't. You had to be a jerk about it. Latchkey, it's kind of whatever. And a Krampus fight. Oh boy. Not a great run. Two of Diamonds, so thank you, game. Thank you. Where was the Two of Diamonds on our last Money Equals Power run? Not that we needed it, of course. Ooh, man. Alright, Curse the Unknown. One thing I do know is that we've got a lot of HP. Red Heart HP, that is. Get him, Spider. There we go. Now, funnily enough, the portals don't count as mobs for Jar of Flies. And that's something they started a gurgling right in front of us in this room. Now that's pushing the envelope of what's okay and what's not okay, game. That's pretty cheap. I mean, gurgling's off to the side, I can definitely understand. And I will manage that. But having a third gurgling in the middle right in front of the door as soon as we walk in is a little bit ridiculous. Looks like we gotta go up and over. Or not. I saw the boss room is like above this room. Maybe it wraps around? This room can just fudge right off. I said fudge. Fudge, don't worry, put your pitchforks down. Here's a question that I don't think anyone's ever asked before. I've got a brand new product for you. And you would think that in our outrage society these days, we would have had something that was invented for this reason, but surprisingly, we have not. At least not that I know of, anyway. I present to you, instead of the pitchfork, we have the bitch fork. And it's made only with the protester in mind. Someone offending you? Have you been triggered by someone or something that was completely unrelated to you these days? Reach for the bitch fork. Probably deserve that. That'd be a... I mean, the products write themselves for the product placements.
Two of clubs.
I'd buy one. I'd buy one just to have it. I'd hang it up on my wall. Not even on my wall. I'd hang it up in my wall. Alright. Super secret room. Not there. I don't think it's going to be there. Alright. Well, this is going to be very interesting here with our damage. I mean, 6.92 is not bad damage. It's just... it's not, like, amazing damage. I mean, we can't always have Polyphemus Magic Mush Mom's Knife on a run, you know? And I'm glad that we can't, because that would make this game very boring. Our movement speed is just so bad. Guppy's Paw and... Succubus. I did that first because I don't know how much HP we have. And we will just head on up. Thank you, Goathead. I'm not going to fight Delirium on a run like this, of course. No curse. Thank you very much. I mean, the t-shirts would also sell pretty well for the bitch fork, I think. You're swearing on the video. That's not really... I mean, is the B word a swear these days? I don't think it is. I've seen videos, man, of these, like, little kids. I mean, just... context. Okay. I have seen videos of undisciplined children, it seems like, where they just go on, like, cursing tirades on YouTube. I mean, there's one, it was like, and I realize that, like, I understand why these sorts of videos would be there, but, like, it's still, like, I can't help but feel wrong when I see or hear a little girl who's, like, she's probably, like, 6 or 7 years old, and she's trying to take a picture with, like, either her mother or her older sister or something like that, and she says, like, she's like, what the F is taking so long? But she, like, actually curses there. And I'm like, this girl can't be more than 7 years old. You know. I know that back in the day, if I said that in anywhere of any parent's earshot, not even my own, any parent's, they were pretty much obligated to just beat the hell out of you. That's just not something you say as a little kid, you know. I mean, I'm not passing judgment here. If you don't care about your kids swearing, then, you know, hey, they're your kids, not mine. But all I will say is that I always feel like it's weird. And, you know, it's just a little weird because when I was that young, that we would never ever say anything like that. I don't know.
You're just a wuss, Victor.
Look. Oh my goodness, 2020. Holy shot. Take Lost Fly. I think we do have enough. I probably shouldn't have taken Fate's Reward. Quad Shot, however, I will take. Sad Onion is fantastic. Wafer makes this a one run by far. More like by way far. Alright. He's Teleporter, and we. That wasn't the teleporter. Why did I think that was a teleporter? It was the blue hourglass. You idiot. Huh, that's interesting. So the items actually changed the chest that they were in. No, we did it. I knew we had the teleporter. I just happened to pick up the blue hourglass instead. Okay, let's try this again. Wafer, thank you very much. I will take Fate's Reward just for the lulz. At this point. Now we use the teleporter. Thank you. Yeah, expect to see that often. Oh, okay. Never mind. Don't expect to see that often because we're here. So, thank you for watching, everyone. Whoo, man. What a run. So, I do appreciate all the support on the Isaac series. Hope you enjoy this seed as well. Man, this is just... Look at this. This is just a burning pyre of goodness on right on top of Blue Baby's face. Good run in the end. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Make sure you subscribe here to the channel so you get all my latest videos. Make sure you ring the notification bell as well so you get notified when they actually go live. Sometimes maybe, sometimes not, because who knows what YouTube actually does these days. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.